Hello everyone. Today we are going to tell a story about a young brave nurse who volunteered to serve in Sabah during the third wave. She was willing to risk her own life to play her role as a dedicated nurse in combating the virus. It is written by Mr. Vignesh Nair, myself Maidali, Ms. Cassandra and Ms. Divya. And it was illustrated by Irda Abdul Rahman. There has always been this will in Abhinaya to help the needy. When she was young, her grandmother was a source of inspiration who loved helping the needy. Be the light that shines in everyone's heart, for you are destined to assist injured souls one day. She said, her grandmother always believed that Abhinaya is special and her purpose in life is to serve. Becoming a nurse has always been her ambition, and after graduating from Perlis Community Nursing College, she pursued her dream job as a staff nurse in Hospital Kuala Lumpur. For the past 4 years, she has been working long hour shifts in the intensive care unit, taking care of patients on ventilators. In 2020, the COVID-19 pandemic occurred and extra precautions were taken by all the staff in the hospital. During the third wave of the COVID-19 pandemic, a message was received that Queen Elizabeth Hospital in Sabah was in dire need of staff nurses who are well versed in the ICU department. They were not only understaffed, but most of the nurses were burned out due to the sudden spike of cases. It was indeed a hard decision to make, and she was on the fence. What am I supposed to do? She asked herself in a perplexed mood. As she looked around and saw her colleagues working relentlessly to battle the virus, she decided to step forward to lend a hand in Sabah. Before making any decision, she called her father, who was in Kedah, and told him her intention.
Abi, it has been months since you came home, and now you choose to go further away.
I chose this path so I can serve the people. I see every patient as my family, Pa. I'll be back soon. Till then, pray for me to have the strength to help the needy. Few days later, the head of the staff nurse called Abhinaya and 30 of her colleagues who had volunteered for an urgent meeting. They had only 3 days to prepare for the trip, and at the same time, they had to prepare their belongings, get swab tests from the COVID-19 departments, and care for their current patients in the ICU unit. They listened attentively during the briefing and took as many notes as possible. It was nerve-wracking as none of them had any experience in dealing with patients who contracted the virus in the ICU unit. The next day, a representative matron of the KPJ hospital came to the hospital and gave them a second briefing on their trip. He informed them that they will be in Sabah for a month and they are required to go through a 14-day quarantine once they are back to Kuala Lumpur. They were uncertain of the location of their quarantine, yet they were told everything would be arranged accordingly when they returned. They prepared their luggage and the documents needed for the trip. They had to follow multiple strict procedures such as making police reports, checking in and confirming their IDs and documents. As the 30 of them sat together in the waiting lounge, she could see the fear in everyone's eyes. One of the staff nurses was kissing her son goodbye through her mobile phone and another was in tears, leaving behind her husband and children. They knew for the next 30 days, they needed to be strong mentally and support one another. They arrived in Sabah late at night and they were sent to their hotel, which was nearby the hospital. They were not allowed to stay in pairs or groups. For their safety purpose, they were given a room each. They bid goodbye and went to their rooms respectively for a good night's sleep. The next day, the head matron explained their task and they learned how to wear the PPE, which was different in HKL. The procedures to wear the PPE were rigid. She was required to wear an astronaut-like suit, which was equipped with an oxygen supply device. Abhinaya had to wear the PPE for 7 hours, and she would be worn out by just the act of wearing and removing the PPE. She was required to handle COVID-19 patients who were under ventilator support in the ICU ward. Unlike in HKL, every move she took needed to be authorized by the doctor in charge, including assessing the patients. Everything was computerized and she needed to key in her daily report accordingly. Understanding the settings of the ventilators were complex and challenging too, and it took her a while to actually learn the suitable setting to treat chronic COVID-19 patients. Time was the essence and she was required to learn all the pertinent procedures as fast as possible. It was heartbreaking to witness the suffering of the ventilated and intubated patients. Due to the infection, the patients were not able to breathe on their own. She had to closely monitor the patients to see any signs of recovery, and if their lungs collapsed, the chances to revive them were low and they would eventually pass away. There was once when she was about to start her shift and she saw one of her colleagues was weeping alone. It happened too fast. 1 minute he was fine and the next he stopped breathing. I should have been more alert, she said tiredly as Abhinaya was trying to soothe her broken spirit. Abhinaya could only assuage her pain as there was nothing they could do. As her shift came to an end, Abhinaya was required to remove her PPE and showered in the hospital before going back to the hotel. As she looked out the window, she was dejected to see the lack of awareness among the people, as some chose to violate the standard operating procedure, SOP. There is still a long way to go, but we will not quit until we have won the battle. That's all from us. We hope we have showed you a glimpse of a frontliner's journey in combating the virus. Thank you. Who was kind enough to cut out a big chunk of the time in order to contribute her story to us. And presenting, these are our authors. And this is our talented illustrator, Miss Ilda binti Abdul Rahman, who has graduated from IPG Tunku Bainun Pulau Pinang and is now currently teaching at SK Bandar Baharu Kulim, Kedah. Thank you.